We're making and planning and playing games while making a video.
So do we get to see the show?
You guys guess how many fans of the game?
How many pencils? It doesn't seem like you approve of this hobby.
Like, my mom. My mom doesn't, but I do.
I've never known someone to have such an extensive collection. This is a new thing for me.
Now he has a cabinet.
He has a 100. I know 100, but that's only not anymore.
Only like right here and here, 100 pencils.
Hi, I'm Christy. I'm one of the teachers in the school program, and we are doing a Let's Read TV segment on sports books. And we have Karandeep. He is going to be speaking to us about basketball.
Tell us what book you're holding in your hand.
It's a book about basketball and the basic things about it. Okay, my baby, his full name is Michael Bibby, and he's 6'1". His birthday is May 13th, 1978, and he was born in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. He went to University of Arizona, and he has 3 children, and he lives with his girlfriend, Percy Watkins. These are his stats for this year. And he plays guard on the team. They play in Sacramento in the Arco Arena.
And how did they do this past season?
Not that good.
Karandeep is going to help me talk a little bit about Mike Bibby and his position. So what position, can you refresh our memories about what
point
position?
Guard.
He plays point guard. And what does a point guard do?
He's like the main person on the team. He's like the one that does all the play and he calls all the plays and does all the passing and stuff.
And then defensively, what does he do?
He helps his other teammates try to steal the ball and take it and try to shoot the
back on their basket.
Yeah.
Right? Okay.
So
would you recommend this book to a child who wants to learn more about basketball?
I guess so, yeah.
And why?
I have most of the main plays and stuff like these.
So learning about playing basketball,
mm-hmm.
How to shoot, how to dribble, how to pass. It talks about all those different kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
And then it has some nice pictures. Did you want to show the picture of... Who is that?
Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan.
When he was on the Chicago Bulls. Most famous for his dunks. And sticking his tongue out. On video games, you just use your hand, but in here you could read it and actually try it in when you park or wherever.
Happy reading.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. I'm out of here.
Doctor, I swallowed a bone. Are you choking? No, I really did.
What's that, Doc?
Okay. This is, one day, man. He's new in the city, he goes to one of the hotels, and the manager gets on the available room, and that one night, midnight, he heard this noise. When I get you, I'm gonna eat you. He hears it, he jumps out, and he gets scared, jumps out the window. And the next day, another person comes, and that person asked for a room. There were no other rooms except for that one. And the manager warned them that the person who still wanted it, they go in there. When I get you, I'm gonna eat you. And the third guy, he's a, it's a lady. She goes there, and the same thing happens at midnight. And she also, the last guy, he goes in there, and at midnight when he hears it, he follows it. And he finds he notices it coming out of the closet, opens it, there's a kid there going, sticking a finger in the nose, when I get you, I'm gonna eat you.
Did you used to watch Nickelodeon?
Yes.
Did you know Rocko's Modern Life?
Yeah.
Academics is Big Head. Ed, oh Ed! Rocko, would you mind sipping me up? I'm so embarrassed.
That's cool.
That's pretty good.
And Filbert. Oh, look. You turn the page, you wash your hands. You turn the page, you wash your hands. Do you know Macy Gray?
I try to say goodbye and I choke. Try to walk away and I stumble. Though I try to hide it, it's clear my world comes down when you are right near.
What do you think, Karandeep? Do we have Macy Gray with us or what?
You should go to Broadway.
Are you gonna make a Facebook yet?
Yeah. That's attractive. Okay, we're gonna make that as a group shot. Wait, no, save up. Save the energy for the face. You are just too much. These are funny and yet not funny. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here we begin, Karandi. Steven Spielberg was discussing his new project, an action docudrama about famous composers starring top movie stars. Sylvester Stallone, Steven Seagal, Bruce Willis, and Arnold Schwarzenegger were all present. Spielberg strongly desired the box office oomph of these superstars, so he was prepared to allow them to select whatever composers they wished to portray as long as they were famous. Well, started Stallone, I've always admired Mozart. I would love to play him. Chopin has always been my favorite, and my image would improve if people saw me playing the piano, replied Willis. I'll play him. I've always been partial to Strauss and his waltzes, said Seagal. I'd like to play him. Spielberg was very pleased with these choices. Sounds splendid. Then, turning to Schwarzenegger, he asked, who do you want to be, Arnold? Arnold, in a slow, deliberate voice, replied, I'll be back. One, two, three, four.
Hey, that's pretty good. That's like your thing.
Maybe you could quack like a chicken.
Nah, you could do that, please.
Can do any impressions?
Hey, that was good.
Mm-hmm. I like the eyes that go with that.
She's saying like my aunt.
I know you're stuck with me. One of those family members you can't get rid of.
Okay, let's see.
Let me see your funny face. Is that your funniest face? Huh? That's good for your little comedy show here. This is Karandeep's funny face.
I could do one.
My grandma used to do this. She'd do like this, where she'd pull the ear. This.
Stay with your tongue. Do this with your mouth. You do look like Bill Cosby.
You see, you hear the jello pudding pop.
I love it.
I don't want to be funny, though.
Go ahead and be funny.
Well, I don't really have to make faces. I kind of have a funny face to begin with. I got a big space in between my teeth. I got kind of a big nose, so I don't really have to make any faces. I'm already kind of funny looking to begin with. So, and you, who are so beautiful, I don't know if I could even be in this next to you.
Bye-bye.
I like that. Okay, so I'm going to say a person's name, and then you say what comes to your mind, okay? And it can be funny or serious or whatever.
Okay.
All right, we'll start with the easy target. Jim.
Weird.
Julie.
Nice.
Janelle. That's your nose, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Christy.
Nice.
Oh, you can't use nice for everybody.
Gog and Deep.
Crazy.
And if you need to use more than one word, you can.
Your mom.
Nice. Very nice.
Your dad.
Very nice.
Grandma.
Very nice. Dr. Olby. Dr. Loger.
Okay, Goldsby.
Dr. Lou. Okay, Dr. Goldsby. Very energetic.
One of my favorite things about you is that I think you have, you're so good natured, and you have a really warm personality, very friendly, and you're a real jokester, and I like that a lot about you.
He's a good kid, intelligent kid, you know, you can see from all the books he's reading, his pencils, he likes to study, and I wish him a recovery from this disease.
Yeah. Oh, well, I haven't known Karandeep very long, just ever since we met and I pushed him into doing the sports book report, which I'm so sorry that I was so pushy that day, to help Christy with her project, but Karandeep was a very good sport. Do you want your mom to answer?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes, definitely mom for me. I want to hear what she has to say for me.
He's a naughty boy.
Hey! Hey! You cannot say that about me on this camera.
ਉਹੀ ਮਤਲਬ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਦੇ ਕਲਚਰ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਪੂਰੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਸਮਝਦਾ ਸੀ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਨਾਲ ਪਿਆਰ ਸੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਨਾਲ ਪਿਆਰ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਵੱਖਰੀ ਜਿਹੀ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਸੀ ਆਮ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਉਹ ਇੱਥੇ ਦੇ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਆ ਇੱਥੇ ਦਾ ਬਾਰਡਰ ਹੋਣ ਦੇ ਨਾਤੇ ਵੀ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਦੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਪੁਰਾਣੇ ਬਜ਼ੁਰਗਾਂ ਦੀ ਇਸ ਬਾਰਡ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਸ਼ਿਕਸ਼ਾ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਹੈ
ਪੰਜਾਬ
ਵੱਡੀ ਗੱਲ ਆ ਕਿ ਇੱਥੇ ਓਲਡ ਨੂੰ ਥੋੜ੍ਹੀ ਮਦਦ ਕਰਦੇ ਆ
He's an uncle.
Okay, uncle.
Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Yeah. Okay. The aunt.
Aunt right here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The grandma.
Grandma.
Uh-huh. And the aunt. Other aunt.
And the other aunt who just came from India directly.
Yeah.
From the airport. Yeah.
He was playing with his uncle. He was little. He had long hair. Four or five years ago.
How long was his hair?
Too long.
2 years.
He used to wear the star.
Yeah.
He turban.
For a
the turban.
So that it will be like down here somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Your waist, he has a very, very long hair.
So did you
first time he, you know, the hair.
I should already call.
He's crying. Mm-hmm. This garbage can is full. Fluffy hair. I'm nursing God. She said, oh my God, you have a still over there. Too much.
So
that time is first time. It's too much. Cry too much. He don't want.
He used to play with his mom every year. We used to see him in February, and he had a prayer. One of his uncles had a prayer every year here in February. We used to see him in the Bible playing with his mom and, you know, her brother.
And every year in February,
yeah,
they would go. And you're in Yuba City too?
No, yeah.
Okay, in
Sankt. And we all are, you know, too many functions in the year, and we together, and we go together. We're going over there too, we go over there. We meet.
We had an exciting wedding recently.
He and other children just sit in the one of the door in the Gurdwara, and they joke and laugh and advertise. And his brother, others, you know, tell them, I'm going to take you to McDonald's and have a good time.
Really?
He had children when he was 5, 6 years old.
Is that when the joke started, Karandeep?
Yeah.
Is that where you learned
to play tricks?
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like my uncle, he's like a big trickster.
Yeah, your mama,
you. Yeah, my uncle.
Big cheater.
See? Everyone knows it. His little tricks, he does. Secrets and everything.
Is he your older or younger brother?
He's younger, but he's still kid. He's married, but he's still a kid. He's 31 years old, but still he's a kid. He acts like he's playing the kids. Whenever we go to his house, he's always like playing. You know, right now it's PlayStation 2 and or PSP. He's always playing us. I always see him playing something. Video game.
He come here and he plays the video game.
Wherever he goes.
He and Ajay play video game all the time.
Yeah.
His cousin.
My cousin.
What's the biggest trick he ever played, Karandeep, that you remember?
Cheating on one of the games that we play with playing cards.
Do you catch him when he's cheating?
sometimes.
Oh,
yeah.
Does he catch you?
He catches us. He tries to catch us, and then right at the end, we find out he's been cheating too.
Surprise! It's very competitive, I can tell.
His cousin sister? Mom, his cousin sister?
She's like.
She likes sandpaper.
She like him.
Let me see if
it
might be.
Was it?
Jim!
Wow!
Now, don't worry, Jim. You don't have to have Karandeep teach you how to tell better jokes in front of everybody. I know that was what we were going to do today in the comedy show. You're off the hook because the family is sharing stories about Karandeep, but just meant overall family stories.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Although Karandeep might still want to put you on the spot. So.
Okay. Well, I'll interrupt. I'll come back later to do a pencil exchange.
I want to see him. I want to see him.
You can see him later.
Okay. My name.
Karandeep, you're getting quite the reputation for being very good about keeping pencils. What's that?
I know that. I'll tell you guys about that later.
Later. Okay. Do you want your grandma to tell some stories?
Yeah.
Grandmother, no, she could tell stories about my dad.
India.
Yeah, about my dad.
India. You go India and...
No, not those stories. My dad's
story. What?
Like one when Jaja falls into and there's like a little ditch with water in it. A big old ditch with water in it. My uncle falls into it. My dad's like walking by it. They're like, who cares? And everyone else is like all jumping, going around, trying to... Get him out. My dad doesn't even care.
That's
a little too.
Okay.
That
sounds like a story we need to
hear.
I know.
No, that's too little. Oh my god, that's a little too private.
No, that's not private.
Yes,
in
it
India,
is.
Not private.
I know, but it is over here.
Well, now we're really curious.
Oh, go ahead, I'll close my ears.
How do you do that?
Like in India, the pump, like the big pump, like water, when he went to visit India, he took a bath in a funnel water from two wells, like the open area, like the field. He takes shower over there.
Yeah.
And grandma, she checked him like the over there, the field only like the pool, like little pool.
Uh-huh.
He takes showers.
Showers?
Only in. Only maybe underwear? You wear the underwear? No.
Probably not, because that's why he's so embarrassed.
Yeah. We have pictures. He's the first time he go in India.
94.
94. He's old. 4 year old.
Huh? 4 year old.
Next, he 8 year old and Gagandeep is 4.
Well, that must be fun to play in the field.
Yeah.
and to take a shower in the field. That's cool.
They're too much fun.
Yeah. You don't have to be so modest.
Okay. I don't like that story.
You don't like that story?
it's like too much of a... and telling about
he loved the dogs over there.
That
he bring the neighbor's dog.
Whenever I see a dog, I would bring it. I didn't care who it was. I was just peeing.
Oh my gosh, there's so many stray dogs in India. You must have had a lot of dogs at home.
But they got mad a little bit, so they would make me let it go.
Because
I would tie it. You know, I would tie it on the little bed thing that they had would have outside. It's like a bed made with the wood for legs and rope where it's tied onto it.
Yeah.
And then with blankets and everything on top of it. And then I would tie it onto the legs, keep it near me, play with it, you know. And my grandpa or someone would get mad at me, and then I would just pull the rope and
throw it anyway. Did the dogs like it? Being under all those blankets and being tied up?
No, I would pull them there. Even if they didn't want to go, I would pull them.
They have too many cookies.
Yeah, I would pull them, and then once they started getting used to me, they would come on my own self. Oh, the bulls.
He has a picture too.
Bulls.
Bulls?
Bull.
Yeah.
Like, you know, the cows and bulls.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Bull.
And you brought those home too?
No. No, I would just ride on them. Ride on the cows.
You would ride on them?
Yeah, and then they would be hooked up to a cart.
Like,
and a car, like a wooden little thing, and I would like sit on the side, and my friend or whoever I would look, I would sit on the other side, and I would like, you know, hold the strap and then tell them which way to go and everything. And so it's like a horse. So they're like horses. They were used as like horses, but there was a bigger. They were used in greater amounts and bigger stuff to like bigger little car things and like.
And where did you went in the streets or in the fields?
Streets everywhere, like for
because
streets.
There's probably I don't know where you are, but I know that there's traffic everywhere. Lots of activity.
Not those kind of streets, but the wood. No, the dirt roads.
So it was not too scary to be on top of the roads. Wondering.
But being behind them, yeah.
They kick you.
Almost got kicked.
But you didn't.
But luckily, my friend's dad, he was in there. I was behind his bull. I didn't know. I got annoyed by it because it was moving his tail and it hit me. And I'm like, I actually grabbed it. The bulls picked me. But luckily, my uncle's dad pulled me away before he even got me. And then I did fireworks there, even when I did fireworks.
Everybody, kids, gave him pencils, pen, everybody gave. And he came home and I asked him, what to do, what are this? Like, he tell me, all kids, school, they gave for him everything, like pencils, pen, erasers, like that. He has a big bag, his pencil, his pen, and erasers.
They just gave you stuff because you are traveling, you're coming from America?
Yeah, they like
that's
me.
Why.
Wow.
They like.
So hospitable. Yeah.
They like your personality,
yeah.
Too.
Yeah. They like.
Now, what's your pet peeve about people not telling jokes well?
They turn out boring.
They turn out boring. So how do you really feel? Like, what should people do if they want to tell a joke?
Make sure they know it well.
And then your cousin. You get some jokes from
cousin, yeah. He has some weird jokes.
Okay. What about your parents? Do they tell jokes sometimes?
No.
Or are they just funny people?
They're funny.
Yeah.
They just do funny stuff. I go to them.
What about Log and Deep?
Log and Deep. He makes like funny all the time.
And your grandma?
She's serious all the time.
She doesn't seem like she's serious all the time.
She is.
She's serious, Grandma.
She is sometimes.
Okay. And then what about people here? We know Jim has a silly side, and with your help, you're going to help him become an even better joke teller. Anybody else that's pretty funny here?
Michael.
Michael's pretty funny. I would agree with that. Who told you that joke? Your cousin, is that where you get a lot of your material? Does your cousin tell jokes pretty well?
Yeah, but they're the bad ones. This is the only good one that you could tell.
That was the only clean one.
The good one, I could
tell
you. Okay, one.
Hey.
Oh.
Hey, I think that passed the Karandeep test.
What animal did Noah not trust? Noah not trust. Noah.
I don't know.
The cheetah.
Nah. Wanted to film yourself telling jokes.
Why is that light on? Turn it off.
You want the camera off?
Cut.